Students, today I'll teach you the remaining part of the chapter tissues. You have already learned about plant tissues. Today I'll teach you about animal tissues. Now there are four types of animal tissue: epithelial, muscular, nervous and connective tissue. Now epithelial tissue is classified into squamous, cuboidal, ciliated and columnar. Muscular tissue is classified into voluntary muscles, cardiac muscles, involuntary muscles. Next, connective tissue is classified into connective tissue proper, skeletal tissue and fluid connective tissue. So students, you will learn the flow chart given over here on page number 16. Next, let us come to the first type of animal tissue, that is epithelial tissue. Now epithelial tissue, first you must know the location of epithelial tissue. So epithelial tissue covers the external surface of the body as well as lines the cavities of internal organs. Now coming to its structure or shape. Now the cells of epithelial tissue, they do not have intercellular spaces and their shape may be either flat or cuboidal or columnar. Coming to the function of epithelial tissue, it provides protection and prevents the entry of germs. Now, on the basis of shape, epithelial tissue is classified into four types. One is squamous, second cuboidal, third columnar and fourth ciliated epithelium. So in each you have to know the structure and location. So squamous epithelium consists of single layer of cells. The cells are flat, they have a nuclei and they are placed on a basement membrane. Now coming to its location, it is found in the lining of blood vessels and the inner lining of cheek. Coming to the structure of cuboidal epithelium, it's composed of single layer of cuboidal cells resting on a basement membrane. And now the location, they are present in the salivary glands and the thyroid glands. Next is columnar epithelium, the structure of the cells. They are tall, cylindrical and nuclei is present at the base of the cells. And next, the location, present in the inner lining of intestine. The last one of epithelial tissue is ciliated epithelium. Now the structure of these cells is they are the epithelial cells, but they have hair like cilia on their free surface. The location of it is they are present in the windpipe or trachea, the inner lining of windpipe or trachea has ciliated epithelial cells. Next, coming to the second type of animal tissue, that is connective tissue. Now connective tissue connects one group of tissues to another in our body. It is also called as joining tissue. It joins, why it's called joining tissue? Because it joins various organs of the body. Turn to page number 18. The flow chart which is given over here, this one you will learn. That is, connective tissue is classified into three types. One is connective tissue proper. Second is supportive skeletal tissue or supportive connective tissue, and third one is vascular tissue. Now coming to connective tissue proper, they are again of four types: areolar, adipose, tendon, ligament. Supportive is again of two types: cartilage, bone, and vascular is again of two types: blood and lymph. Let us come to the first type of connective tissue, that is connective tissue proper, in that areolar tissue. Now location of areolar tissue: it forms a continuous layer under the skin, fills up the spaces between various organs. Mainly it is called as a, or it is a packing material. Function: it gives support and helps in movement of various organs and tissues. Now coming to the next type of connective tissue proper, that is adipose tissue. It is made up of cells called as adipocytes. Location of adipose tissue: it is found beneath the skin and between the internal organs. Function of adipose tissue: it is mainly a storage tissue, so it stores fat. Now next, coming to the third type of connective tissue proper, that is tendon. Now come to the, just see this table which is given over here, difference between ligament and tendon. So ligament and tendon are different types of connective tissue proper. So you will learn the differences between tendon and ligament based on the points which I am telling. So first of all, the difference between the definition, difference between ligament and tendon based on definition. So ligament connects two bones, whereas tendons connect bones to muscles. Ligaments are elastic, whereas tendons have limited flexibility. Ligaments contain little matrix, whereas tendons have more matrix. Ligaments have yellow fibrous connective tissue, whereas tendons have white fibrous connective tissue. Coming to the next type of connective tissue, that is skeletal tissue. Now skeletal tissue is of two types: one is cartilage, another one is bone. Now where the location of cartilage? Location of cartilage, where it is found: it occurs in windpipe and at the end of the bones of fore and hind limbs. It's also present in the walls of respiratory passages such as nose and trachea, air, pinna, epiglottis. Now what is the function? It gives support and provides elasticity to the soft tissues. Now coming to bone. Now the location of bone: it is the endoskeleton of the body. Function of it: it forms the framework that supports the body. Now difference between bone and cartilage you will learn. Now let me just tell you the differences point wise. First, bone has matrix which is hard, whereas cartilage has matrix which is elastic. Now the bone has got the matrix which is having a protein called osin, whereas cartilage has the protein called chondrin. In the matrix of bone, salts are present. In the matrix of cartilage, no salts are present. Now what is this matrix? It is actually in the intercellular space, a fluid is present which is called as matrix. In between the cells, a fluid is present which is called as matrix. Now in case of bone, the matrix is arranged in rings which are called as lamellae, and Haversian canal is present. Whereas in cartilage, the matrix is not arranged in rings and they do not have canals. That is, they do not have Haversian canals. Next is bones. They are not flexible, but they are porous. Whereas cartilage, they are flexible and they are non-porous. Blood vessels are present in bones, whereas cartilage, they do not have blood vessels. So coming to the next type of connective tissue, that is vascular connective tissue. They are vascular connective tissue is of two types. One is blood, another one is lymph. Now blood consists of a fluid part which is called as plasma, and it has got cellular part also. Now the cellular, what are the cells present in blood? RBC, that is red blood corpuscles, WBC or white blood corpuscles, and blood platelets, also called as thrombocytes. Now one main function of blood is it helps to transport substances from one part to another inside the body. So what are these substances? They may be nutrients, they may be dissolved gases, etc. Now move to the next page, that is the another type of vascular tissue, that is lymph. Now lymph, what is lymph? It is colorless and it is blood plasma without RBC and proteins. Now one main function of lymph is it brings carbon dioxide and waste from tissues to blood, and nutrients, oxygen, hormones from blood to tissues. Next, this table which is given here, differences between blood and lymph, you will learn. Now I'll just go through these differences point wise. Blood has a red color or is red in color, whereas lymph is colorless. Red blood cells are present in blood, whereas lymph do not have red blood cells. They have large protein molecules. Blood has large protein molecules, whereas lymph they do not have large protein molecules. Blood flows in blood vessels, whereas lymph flows in lymph vessels. Now move to the next, that is muscular tissue. Muscular tissue is another type of animal tissue. Now muscular tissue, we will learn the muscular tissue in form of table which is given on page number 22. Now, comparison of three types of muscles. What are the three types of muscles or muscular tissue is classified into three types. One is skeletal, second is smooth, and third is cardiac. The differences between these three we will learn point wise. So, you will learn this table, students. Now, let us come to the differences. First, shape. Now, skeletal muscles are striped. Smooth muscles are unstriped. Cardiac muscles are striped. Next is about the shape again. They have striations. They are unstriated. They have striations. Cardiac muscle. That is, striated muscles or skeletal muscles have striations. Smooth muscles, they do not have striations. Whereas cardiac muscle has striations. Now next is about their shape. They are, that is the skeletal muscles, they are long and cylindrical, non-tapering, unbranched. Smooth muscles are spindle shaped and cardiac muscles are cylindrical and branched. Next, coming to their function. Skeletal muscle helps in movement as they are attached to skeleton. And these smooth muscles, they control movement of substances along tubes, whereas cardiac muscles, they help in pumping the blood. Now, location where they are present. Skeletal muscles are attached to skeleton. Smooth muscles are mainly present in tubular organs. They are present in gut. What is gut? It's alimentary canal, mainly the stomach and intestine. They are also present in reproductive system, glands, bronchioles. These bronchioles are finer branches of bronchi. That is, next is cardiac muscle, where they are present. They are present in the heart. Now, which type of control they do? The skeletal muscles, they are voluntary, and smooth muscles, they are involuntary, and what cardiac muscles, they are also involuntary and myogenic. Myogenic means related to heart muscles. Now, voluntary means under our control. Involuntary means not under our control. The last type of animal tissue is nervous tissue. Now, nervous tissue is made up of neurons or nerve cells. Now, the structure of nerve cell, you will go through this diagram which is given over here. The structure of nerve cell. Nerve cell has got cytosol, it has got dendrons, dendrites, axon and axon endings. Now, next is the location of nervous tissue. They are located in the brain and spinal cord. Now, next is about the function of nervous tissue. Main function of it is, there are three functions given over here. You will learn any one. Mainly this one, that is, it coordinates the functioning of different body parts. Difference between axon and dendrite, you will go through this table. And the function of axon is, it carries impulses away from cell body, whereas dendrites carry impulses towards the cell body. So next day we will do the exercise of this chapter.